It's astonishing, but clean energy from the sun, solar energy, has become the cheapest way to generate electricity.
As nations throughout the world look for sustainable energy sources, and the United States strives to have a net zero emissions economy by 2050, renewable energy sources like solar panels are in high demand. In order to address the world's increasing energy needs, polymer-based solar cells have emerged as a possible substitute for conventional silicon solar cells. They are also more cost-effective and less harmful to the environment. Researchers and investors alike have been paying close attention to the advancement of polymer-based solar cells as the whole community continues to look for sustainable energy sources. The solar business could undergo a revolution thanks to this groundbreaking technology, which would increase solar energy's efficiency and accessibility. The fact that polymer-based solar cells are less expensive to produce than silicon-based solar cells is one of their main advantages. The main component of conventional solar cells, silicon, is expensive to produce and labor-intensive to make. Organic resources, which are more affordable and accessible, are used to create polymer-based solar cells, which are the opposite. The ability to compete on price with fossil fuels and increase the use of solar energy globally depends on this cost advantage. Polymer-based solar cells are more cost-effective than silicon solar cells, and they also have a less detrimental effect on the environment. In addition to producing a lot of trash and requiring a lot of energy, the manufacturing of silicon solar cells also increases greenhouse gas emissions. Polymer-based solar cells, on the other hand, have a considerably cleaner and less energy-intensive manufacturing process, which reduces their carbon footprint. As a result, people seeking to invest in green technology and lessen their environmental effect may find them to be a desirable option. The flexibility and low weight of solar cells made of polymers is another advantage. Contrary to solid silicon sun cells, polymer-based solar cells may be formed into thin, flexible sheets that are simple to incorporate into a variety of surfaces, including building facades, windows, and even clothes. As a result, solar power generation has a wider range of uses and opportunities, which increases its adaptability to various conditions and demands. In addition, polymer-based solar cells have the potential to have better efficiencies than conventional silicon solar cells. Recent developments in polymer-based solar cell technology have shown efficiencies surpassing 15%, but silicon solar cells now dominate the market with efficiencies of approximately 20%. Researchers are optimistic that additional advancements in polymer-based solar cell technology may soon result in even better efficiency rates, even though this is still less than silicon solar cells. Despite the fact that the gap is closing, silicon solar cells still have a higher efficiency rate. Although polymer-based solar cells have many benefits, there are still obstacles to be solved before they can completely replace silicon solar cells. One of the key problems is that, in contrast to silicon solar cells, which can survive for decades, they have a relatively short lifespan. Due to their organic composition, which can be impacted by elements such as heat, moisture, and UV radiation, polymer-based solar cells deteriorate more quickly. To solve this problem and increase the lifespan of polymer-based solar cells, researchers are attempting to create more stable and robust materials. To increase the effectiveness and stability of polymer-based solar cells, additional research and development are required. Even though the technology has advanced significantly recently, much more effort needs to be done to improve it and make it a practical replacement for silicon solar cells on a broad scale. As a possible replacement for conventional silicon solar cells, polymer-based solar cells have the potential to increase the affordability, environmental friendliness, and adaptability of solar energy. It is expected that polymer-based solar cells will play an increasingly significant part in the global shift to sustainable energy sources as research and development on this technology continues to advance. We can contribute to paving the road for a cleaner, greener future for future generations by investing in this cutting-edge technology. And while we are waiting for this, let's go over again how solar panels are made from sand. Yes, you heard it right, it is from sand. And here's how sand, an abundant substance, is converted into something that produces power. Silicon, the main component of solar panels, is derived from sand. Sand gets everywhere and is gritty, abrasive, and annoying. It is also a crucial component of solar panels. You should be happy for sand if you want to put in a solar system at your house so you can stop paying your electric bill and the inflation that keeps driving it up. Now, you can't just go outside, scatter a lot of sand on your roof, and hope that energy would pass through it and into your power outlet. In fact, quite the opposite is true. While sand is a necessary component in the creation of solar cells, not just any sand will do. To produce solar cells that convert sunlight to energy as effectively as possible, the sand used for manufacturing must be high in silicon dioxide and adhere to certain specifications. The components of the solar panels you see on rooftops all around the world are made using extremely complex manufacturing techniques to produce efficient solar cells. What goes into a solar panel? Let's find out. Sand with a high silicon content is refined to remove impurities and generate high purity silicon. This process also results in the creation of silicon ingots. After being melted, silicon is fashioned into cylinder-shaped ingots. Wafer slicing. Using a diamond-edged saw, the silicon ingots are cut into wafers with a thickness that is carefully measured and predetermined. To achieve the best possible balance between light absorption and electrical conductivity, the wafer's thickness is carefully regulated. These wafers, according to expert, serve as each solar cell's basis. The wafers are subsequently subjected to a number of treatments in order to improve their photovoltaic capabilities. Increased light absorption is achieved by the treatment's texturing process. To enable each cell to conduct the electricity, metal connections are attached to the front and back of the cell. Solar panel construction and cell assembly. A solar panel is made up of solar cells that are connected in series or parallel. The desired voltage and current output will be determined by the arrangement. Next, a sturdy glass or other clear material is used to enclose the cells. A frame is then connected to the enclosed cells. The junction box and additional electrical parts are added to the panels by integration of electrical components. The inverter and charge controller may receive the electricity the solar panel produces thanks to these parts. At every level of production, including after assembly, solar panels go through a rigorous quality assurance procedure. Each component must adhere to the necessary performance and reliability criteria, which are helped by this quality assurance process. Monocrystalline and polycrystalline solar panels are the two most popular forms for home use. Individual wafers for monocrystalline solar panels are cut from a single ingot. The monocrystalline cell ingots are distinctively black in color and have a regular cell structure. Monocrystalline solar panels are the most effective and provide the best performance, with ratings ranging from 17% to 22%. These panels typically cost between $1 and $1.50 per watt. However, costs may vary according on region. Monocrystalline panels are all black in appearance, have a 25-year useful life, a modest temperature coefficient, and perform well on hot summer days. Multiple silicon crystals are combined to create polycrystalline solar panels. Many silicon crystals are melted and formed into wafers throughout the manufacturing process. The uneven alignment of the silicon crystals gives these blended wafers a characteristic bluish tint. Polycrystalline solar cells are less efficient than monocrystalline solar cells because of the non-uniform cell structure on the wafer. As a result, polycrystalline solar cell-based solar panels have efficiencies between 15% and 17%. The typical price for these panels ranges from 90 cents to $1 per watt. Polycrystalline panels have a lower temperature coefficient than monocrystalline ones, which means they will perform poor in the heat, but still last up to 25 years. These panels are thus excellent for homeowners who are concerned about their budgets. A thin layer of photovoltaic material, such as amorphous silicon, cadmium telluride, CdTe, or copper indium gallium selenide, CIGS, is applied to a substrate like glass or plastic to create thin film solar panels. These panels are renowned for being both flexible and lightweight, making them appropriate for situations where standard panels might not be practical, like uncurved surfaces or portable gadgets. However, although costing $1 to $1.50 per watt, thin film panels are typically less efficient than monocrystalline and polycrystalline silicon panels. Are you using solar panels? What can you say about the efficiency? Let us know in the comment section below. If you've watched up to this point, thank you so much. For more videos about EVs, Toyota, Tesla, Ford, and the most recent auto news, please consider subscribing to Tech Addicts.